I more or less speak with every applicant which we have, which we which we're allowed to interface with, so to speak. And what we tend to find is that first and foremost, people want security. So there's more and more this saying of treating citizenship like insurance or a wealth portfolio. You know, if you have bank accounts in 5 different countries, why not have citizenship in 3 different countries, you know? Just yesterday, actually, I was talking to this gentleman from Saudi Arabia, and I was like, okay, so why St. Lucia? Why second citizenship? He's like, you know, why not? In this, and that really is it. I think people are becoming a lot more educated. I think that the pandemic has allowed people to realize, hey, these are the problems in my country, either politically, either there's civil unrest, either financially there's an issue. And people are trying to protect themselves in many ways. I think what St. Lucia offers, we offer the usual global mobility. Our passport, more or less all the Caribbean passports are very similar in the offerings which we have for visa-free travel. But what I think St. Lucia offers that's quite unique is really lifestyle, in that St. Lucia is not New York or Dubai, but we're not a country with maybe 20,000 people and a very undeveloped financial system. St. Lucia, fairly large population for the Eastern Caribbean at 180,000. Our government's focus has always been on foreign direct investment. So we have amazing real estate, a really large expat group in St. Lucia, and that makes the country very attractive. Me and Jeffrey, we actually had a lovely British couple who came to St. Lucia like, hey, we want to get a house here. We want to live here eventually. We have a Nigerian woman who's actually in St. Lucia right now, and she's like, she wants to rent something and eventually come to live in St. Lucia. We also have an American who's coming to St. Lucia next week, Friday, and a Brazilian who's coming on Sunday. These people, they see St. Lucia as a potential second home. Maybe they're going to do it next month. Maybe they're going to do it in the next decade. But they see it as a viable option to live should the worst come to fruition. But they also see it as a place where there's opportunity for investment, where you could open a bank account and feel fairly secure, where the government is very neutral and there's not much, if any, political instability. So I think that these factors have worked really well for St. Lucia. And I think that with our increase in development, so right now we're really developing our airport, we're building this beautiful golf course in the north of the island, and this, again, this real distinct focus on development and infrastructure, I think that that is going to bode really well for St. Lucia, and that'll continue the increase in interest which we've seen.